Lewis and Clark Expedition, also known as the Corp of Discovery, was an expedition to explore the West and possibly discover the fabled Northwest Passage. The Northwest Passage was supposed to be an easy east-west water route. It is interesting to note that when the expedition departed, not all of the West was part of the United States. With the Louisiana Purchase completed, the United States acquired lands west of the Mississippi, but much of the Far West still belonged to the Spanish. The expedition started off May 14, 1804, 45 men, a big keelboat, and two smaller pirogues traveling up the Missouri. The journey ends September 23, 1806 when Lewis writes to Thomas Jefferson.
The Corps has penetrated the continent of North America to the Pacific Ocean.
In this video we explore the journal entry written by Lewis on Monday, February 11, 1805. It records the birth of Jean Baptiste Charbonneau, Sacagawea's first child. Fort Mandan was built by the Corps of Discovery as their 1804 to 1805 winter quarters. This historic site is located near the banks of the Missouri River, what is now privately owned land, just west of the city of Washburn, North Dakota. Lewis wrote,
"This place we have named Fort Mandan, in honor of our neighbors."
Sacagawea, a Shoshone woman, was captured by the Hidatsas, an enemy tribe, and sold to the French-Canadian trapper Toussaint Charbonneau. Sacagaweas became Charbonneau's wife at age 12. She was 16 when she gave birth to Jean Baptiste. The birth occurred in the Mandan village in what is now North Dakota. She was invited to join the Lewis and Clark expedition as a Shoshone interpreter. This brings us to the journal entry of Monday, February 11, 1805. Lewis writes,
"The party that were ordered last evening set out early this morning. The weather was fair and could wind northwest about 5 o'clock. This evening one of the wives of Charbonneau was delivered of a fine boy. It is worthy of remark that this was the first child which this woman had borne, and as is common in such cases her labor was tedious and the pain violent. Mr. Jessam informed me that he had frequently administered a small portion of the rattle of the rattlesnake, which he assured me had never failed to produce the desired effect, that of hastening the birth of the child. Having the rattle of a snake by me, I gave it to him, and he administered 2 rings of it to the woman broken in small pieces with the fingers, and added to a small quantity of water. Whether this medicine was truly the cause or not I shall not undertake to determine, but I was informed that she had not taken it more than 10 minutes before she brought forth. Perhaps this remedy may be worthy of future experiments, but I must confess that I want faith as to its efficacy."
And so on Monday, February 11, 1805 in North Dakota, Jean Baptiste was born. He became the youngest member of the Corps of Discovery. After the expedition, he was later adopted and raised by William Clark in St. Louis, Missouri. He spent most of his life in the West as an interpreter, guide and gold prospector. He died on May 16, 1866, probably from pneumonia. His gravesite is near the mouth of Cow Creek, west of present-day Jordan Valley, Oregon. The gravesite is a designated National Historic Place. As for Sacagawea, after leaving the expedition, it is believed she died in 1812 at Fort Manuel, what is now Kennel, South Dakota. She would have been about 24 years old. She was an invaluable member of the expedition. Her name and spirit still lives with us today.